I practiced Kriya Yoga. I first became introduced to the discipline of Kriya Yoga through the book Autobiography of a Yogi. I read this book around 3 years ago, and it was a very, very powerful book for me to read. It really opened my mind, opened my eyes to the truth. Hello, my name is Roby. I come from the U.S. I was living in Los Angeles for a while. I've lived many places in the U.S. I practice Kriya Yoga. I first became introduced to the discipline of Kriya Yoga through the book Autobiography of a Yogi. I read this book around 3 years ago, and it was a very, very powerful book for me to read. It really opened my mind, opened my eyes to the truth, to the power of this ancient science and how it can really change you from the inside out, make you the best version of yourself. So as soon as I read this book, I felt very, very moved. I felt I need to start practicing. I need to meditate every day. I need to have a daily practice. I need to find Kriya Yoga. I need to get this experience. I need to find a real source of this knowledge. At first, I pursued this through the Yogoda Satsanga Association, which in the U.S. is called the Self-Realization Fellowship. And this is the organization that Paramhansa Yogananda established when he came to the U.S. And they have a lesson plan that you can do. It's around 19 lessons. They send you one every 2.5 weeks. It teaches you a lot about the philosophy, the cosmology, the yoga science, as well as a few basic introductory techniques that will prepare you for Kriya Yoga. Think of it like an initiation period of 9 months where you take these lessons. So I received these lessons, I received the learning, the teachings, I practiced the techniques every day. And at the end of the 9 months, you're allowed to apply for initiation to Kriya Yoga. And I didn't feel ready at this moment. I needed to keep practicing. It was inside of me. I knew I had more work to do before I received Kriya initiation. And so maybe another 6 to 9 months pass, and I have a deep moment in meditation. I feel acceptance. I feel ready to receive Kriya Yoga. And I ended up receiving Kriya Yoga from a living guru. This was something that was important to me. I wanted to receive Kriya from someone who is still in the body. Although I'm very strongly connected to Paramhansa Yogananda and the lineage of Self-Realization Fellowship gurus, I wanted a guru who is in the body to give me this technique. And I ended up receiving it from Sri M, who's a guru that lives... He lives in India, but he came to visit in the U.S. I was very blessed to meet him and receive this technique. But still, I craved this deep knowledge, and I craved the authentic experience of being with real yogis and being with people that devote their life to this yoga science, specifically Kriya Yoga. And I knew the real source of this technique, of this tradition, was India. So I felt I had to come. And around 3 months ago, I finally made the trip. I came to India, and at first, I came to the south. I came to Kerala, I came to Tamil Nadu, And one of the most impactful places that I've been on my trip so far was Arunachala, was Thiruvannamalai in Tamil Nadu. This place, the energy is so deep. It resonates deeply in your core. The peace is evident in the air. And I felt very strongly called to visit this place, to visit the holy mountain of Shiva. And when I was there, I did a really intense meditation retreat for 10 days, silent retreat, where I was meditating 9 to 10 hours a day. And this experience was very powerful for me. You really see how the vasanas, the way that your mind works, those mental patterns, if you really get into the meditation, if you really focus internally rather than externally, these patterns lose their strength. You have the seed of the pattern is still there, but you can cut the plant and you can really start to reshape the way that your mind works, reshape the way that you're acting in the world, and really find that internal peace that everyone's searching for, even if they don't know it in the moment. So this is what I would urge you. The science of yoga, the science of meditation, it's so powerful. It really just lets you let go of the suffering of your life, the suffering that you might not even know that you have, the suffering that is that deep feeling in the core of your heart, feeling I'm not where I should be. I'm not right. There's something missing inside of me. For me, this feeling, while it's still there, I can directly express through meditation, and I can let go of this feeling and go into the deeper states of peace. So if you also have felt this feeling, this deep pang of suffering inside of your heart, try meditation, try Kriya. This can really work for you. Om Namah Shivaya.